If you ever ask me what's the coolest way to find the formula for the volume of a sphere, then I will tell you, it has to be using a triple integral. And because we are talking about a sphere, so the best coordinate system that we use is the spherical coordinate system. So here we go. Let's say we have a sphere with radius a, and of course we need an equation. The equation is based on the reference frame that we choose. So I'm going to just do the easy way. Put the center of the sphere to be the origin, and let's say this right here is the x-axis, and then the y-axis, and then the z-axis. Based on this, the equation of the sphere is just simply rho equals whatever the radius is, just like that. And just real quick, this is like saying if you are on the xy plane. We know the equation of the circle like this, center d is 0, 0, is just x squared plus y squared equals whatever the radius is, and then we square that. But that's the rectangular way. On the xy plane, you can also do the polar way. And for the polar way, you can just tell me r is equal to a, and then we are done, right? But of course, when r is equal to a, you also have to mention that the angle theta, you rotate it one time, so from 0 to 2 pi. Yeah? So now, once we are done with the rho, we will have to talk about the two rotations. The rotation theta, which is like our body rotation, it's on the xy plane, starting from the positive x-axis, and we rotate it one time. So that's 0 to 2 pi. And then one more rotation, it's this, right? From 0 to 180 degrees, which is just 0 to 2 pi. And that's the angle phi, 0 to pi. So this is how we can describe the sphere with spherical coordinates. Very nice, huh? Notice they are all constants. So when we set up our volume integral, it's going to be very nice. Now, if we use a triple integral for the volume, 1, 2, 3, right? We just have to do 1 times dv. So here's the deal. I'm going to put down the phi on the very outside, so I'll put that down in blue, and then we have the red one, and then we have the black one. dv in the spherical coordinates system, of course we have the rho, theta, and phi. Yes, we have d rho, and then d theta, and then d phi. Correct. However, remember that there's also some more stuff right here, right? And that is what? Hopefully you guys have seen my previous video. It's rho squared times sine phi. All this right here is the dv in the spherical coordinate system. So this right here, make sure you remember. You can do the Jacobian or you can do geometry. Okay, I will have the link to those videos in the descriptions, so you guys can review it. Now, I put down d rho first, right, in most inner, so I'm going to look at this. It's just a, but it's from the origin to the sphere, so it's 0 to a. Next, theta is 0 to 2 pi. Lastly, phi is 0 to pi. Cool. And now the best part is that all these are constants. And also right here, have a look. Rho squared in the rho world, we can put them together. We can put the sine phi. It's just like constant in the rho world. We can put it outside right here. But that's in the theta world, so it's also like a constant. So we can put that right here, integrating with respect to phi. In fact, we can break down this triple integral, this particular one, into three regular integrals, and then we multiply them. Have a look. The first one that I will do is the blue one, the integral going from 0 to pi, and then I will have the sine phi right here, and then I integrate that with phi, so we have the dv. Next, I will have the red one from 0 to 2 pi, and then we just have d theta. And technically, there's a 1. Lastly, we have the integral going from 0 to a, and then we have rho squared in the rho world, just like this. Yeah, thanks to all this right here being constant, we can just, and also it's just a multiplication, right? So we can do it like this. If this right here are some functions, or this right here is like, if you have rho squared plus sine theta, cannot break it apart anymore, unfortunately. We have to be careful. If it's like that, you know. But anyway though, this is what we have. So just work this out first. So I will have the integral of sine phi being negative cosine phi, and then we go from 0 to pi. Plug that in, we get negative cosine pi, and then minus negative cosine 0. Cosine pi is negative 1, times negative 1 is positive 1, and then minus negative cosine 0 is 1. So it's 1 plus 1. So the result for the blue one is 2. And then for the red one, integrate 1 in the theta world, we get theta. And then plug in. All we care is just plug in 2 pi. That's it. So we get 2 pi. Plug in 0, it's 0. Finally, work this out. We get 1/3 rho to the third power. And then we plug in 0 to a. Plug in a. That's all we need. Plug in 0 is 0. So we multiply by 1/3 a to the third power. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in honor of a triple integral, I'm holding all my triple pens here. 2 times 2 is 4, times 1 is 4. Over 3. Pi is pi, and then the radius is a, and then raise that to the third power. This is for sure the volume of a sphere with radius a. Cool, huh?